Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Good morning and assalamu alaikum to all my lovely students of class 5. This is your teacher Ms. Neera, and today we are back with another revision topic. So as you know that we have completed our syllabus of final term, so today we are going to relearn one of the chapter that is included in your final term. So let's get started. I want all the students to recite Bismillah so we can go ahead. So class, the chapter which we are going to relearn today, or we are going to start the revision of which chapter? The sources of energy. The sources of energy is our chapter number 7 in our overall syllabus, including midterm, but it was the very first topic or the very first chapter of our final term syllabus. It is on page number 49, so I want students to open their books, but turn it. So first of all, we should know about this word, that what does it mean? What is sources of energy? So energy is the word that we are familiar with, but what is sources? Sources is something from which the energy is created. For example, here we are talking about the source. In the background, you can see many of the things, like these are the solar plates. What are these? These are the solar plates. Now, these solar plates are having, can receive the energy from sun, because these are solar plates. So sun is the source of energy. For this, these solar plates, what will they do? They will just capture, they will trap the sunlight, they will convert it into electricity, right? So all these which you can see in the background are sources of energy. Here you can see the windmills. Windmills are very important for creating the energy. Likewise, here you can see the kind of dam or water here you can see. So it means water is also a source of energy, because when the water falls on the generator with a greater speed, so electricity is created. This is how the dams work. Right? So first of all, we should know that what are the sources of energy? Sources is something from which the energy is coming. Right? We can make it very easy that sources is just a thing which is creating the energy, which is just so, which is like from which we can get the energy. Like if we talk about the solar energy, so that is going to be the sun, which is the source of the solar energy, that is the sun. Right? So here one by one we'll talk about the types of energy and their work and how do they work. We shall discuss about that. So solar energy, as I told you, that it is something which is just released from sun. Likewise, there is another kind of energy, which is electrical energy. There is thermal energy. I told you one thing, that when you see this word therm, that always indicates temperature. That always indicates temperature or heat. So thermal energy is something which can give you the heat, for example the fire. Likewise, yesterday we were talking about the sound energy. I told you that sound and light, here we have talked about the light, because light is the form of energy which is coming from the sun. Mainly it is coming from the sun, so that may be similar to the solar energy. But when we talk about the sound, I told you that sound travels in waves. In the form of waves, it transfers the energy. So basically, sound is also the energy. There is a chemical energy as well. There are chemical reactions. Okay, we'll not learn about it because this is something which is in detail. Or you will learn about these things in your secondary classes or the senior classes, and you'll go the next classes 6, 7, 8. Okay, the light energy is something which is the light. Okay, bulb is giving us the light energy. Bulb cannot give us the sound energy, because bulb is made for the light, so it will give the light energy. There is something called mechanical energy as well. Again, we are not supposed to learn it in detail, because that is not the part of our syllabus, so we shall go ahead. So class, first of all, according to your book, there is something which is very important, that is fossil fuels. Fossil fuels, what are these? First of all, you should know that here we are talking about the sources of energy. So again, fossil fuel is something which is a source of energy. But what kind of source it is and how does it give us the energy? We shall learn about it. So what is fossil fuel or what are the fossil fuels? These are the substances. These are the substances that give off heat when they burn. They give off heat when they burn. Let's talk about three main things one by one. Let's talk about the coal that we call in Urdu as koila, petroleum, from which we can take the petrol as well, and methane gas that we use for the cooking as well. Now you can observe one thing. These three things are the things which can capture, which can these can trap the fire very easily. So when these things trap the fire or catch the fire, so they produce heat, and heat is the form of energy. So fossil fuels are the substances that give off heat. Here you need to know two to three things. Number one, fossil fuels, these are not these are the substances. They will give heat when they are burnt. They will only give heat when they are burnt. They were formed millions of years ago from the remains of prehistoric plants and animals. I told you in the physical classes that what are the prehistoric animals and plants. Prehistoric animals and plants are those animals and plants which used to exist. For example, dinosaurs, there are many of the plants which are not right, which are not existing right now, but they used to be existing. They used to exist in the previous era, or you can see that in the history. So how do we know that the dinosaurs were there? We came to know that the creator-like dinosaurs were there because we got their bones, we got their remains, we got their structure, right? So from where we found them? We found them from the underground. So fossil fuels are basically the conversion of those animals and prehistoric plants. It is basically the remains of prehistoric plants and animals, okay? And here comes most of the most important fossil fuels are coal, as I told you, oil or petroleum, and natural gas, which we call as methane gas as well. How they died? Okay, Barira is asking the question, the animals which used to exist or the plants which used to exist, how did they die? किस तरीके से मरे वो बेटा इट इज समथिंग इन लाइक दैट इज नॉट अबाउट योर लेवल बट आई कैन जस्ट टेल यू अ ब्रीफ ऑफ इट देयर वाज मास एक्सटिंक्शन. Mass extinction is something which can everything on the earth would be destroyed, or everything on that area would be destroyed. It is like something that there may be many disasters. There were many natural disasters which just either turned out the land, or either the land was cracked, or animals and plants just fell down. And this is something which can totally destroy all the things which are existing on the land. This is mass extinction. Okay, after the class, if you want to learn about it, you can go to the Google, and if you will write mass extinction, you will come to know that how it occurred. And it did not happen for the one time. It happened many of the times in the life history. Okay, so this is how these plants and animals we can say that they their remains are found under the ground. They are not on the ground. They are not found on the rocks. They are always found under the ground. So from these three fossil fuels, oil, petroleum, and natural gas, first of all, we'll learn about the coal. We know that what is a coal? Coal is basically the remain of plant and animal. The prehistoric plants and animals. Now there are coal mines, koile ki khan, right? So coal mines are there. People or engineers or labor team go there, and they go under the ground. They just mine the coal. They extract the coal from there. The coal which is extracted from the underground, that is not used in its original form. the way it is extracted or mined, it is not used that way. We need to crush it. We need to wash it before use. Okay, because we found it from under the ground. It is not in the usable form. First, we need to separate it. We need to just make it pure. We need to mine it. We need to crush it. We need to wash it before use. Then only in this case, it is usable for us. The coal that we get from the market, it is not that one coal which was extracted from underground. After mine, these were crushed, these were washed, then these are like able to be sold out. Most of the world's electricity is generated with the help of coal. It lies deep under the ground, as I told you that. It is found under the ground. All the fossil fuels are found under the ground, or there are some of the fossil fuels which are also found under the sea. Okay, not only the underground, but under the sea as well. We'll learn about it. But here is the important thing which you need to remember, and that is it serves about 25% of world's energy. It serves about 25% of world's energy. Our world is using energy, different energies. So if we sum up all the energy, so 25% is just being served by coal. So we need to remember that particular percentage for coal, petroleum, and gas, right? So in case of coal, that is 25%. Now here comes another thing. Here you can see the machines in the background. These machines are used to extract something from under the ground. They're drills. But see, these kind of structures are going down under the ground. They are like drill kind of a structure. Why do we use drill machines? We use the drill machines to make the hole on the wall, right? Likewise, there are drill machines which are much larger than the normal drill machines. They are used to make holes in the ground. So machines can go under the ground. They can extract the petroleum, they can extract the gas, they can extract the coal. So let's talk about the oil, that is petroleum as well. It is also called as petroleum. So here I gave you the example of that how we extract the oil from under the ground. Here you can see in this picture that oil or petroleum is also extracted from under the sea. Now let's learn about it. It is also called as petroleum. It is drilled on the land and under the sea. This is important. On the land, under the sea. It means the land is drilled out, or we can get it from under the sea as well. It is used to powering engines and running industries, as you know that all the most of the vehicles need petroleum, petrol, diesel. These kind of things are separated from petroleum. Petroleum and petrol are not same. These are not same. These are different. How these are different? When we as I told you that we cannot use that coal which we extracted from the ground. We need to make it pure first. We need to mine it. We need to crush it. We need to wash it. Likewise, when we extract the petroleum, it is not in usable form. Petroleum is the mixture of oils. Petroleum is the mixture of oils from which one is the diesel and another is the petrol and another is the kerosene. It means there are different oils which are separated from the petroleum. So petroleum is itself not a single kind of oil, but it is the mixture of the oils. And we know that it is used to powering engines in vehicles. We use it. Gasoline, kerosene, and diesel, these are all the things which are separated from petroleum. As I told you that it is not one kind of oil. Now here again you need to remember the percentage when we're talking about the coal. So we got to know that it serves about 25% of world's energy, but when it comes on the oil, it serves more than the coal. It serves about 40% of world's energy. Now what do you see here? What do you see in the background? This is stove on which there is methane gas. So now we are going to learn about the natural gas, which is also known as the methane gas. It is used in cooking. This is so simple. We know that it is used in cooking. And of course, it is used for heating because it is the fossil fuel. When we burn it, it gives heat. It is also nowadays commonly used for powering engines of vehicles. We know that CNG, compressed natural gas. CNG stands for compressed natural gas. That is also used in the vehicles. I think it is cheaper than the petrol or the diesel. So that is why many of the people use just power their engines of vehicle by having the natural gas. Now, here comes the percentage which you need to remember, and that is 25%. That is 25%. Coal serves about 25%. This is 21. Coal serves about 25%. Oil serves about 40%. And now, the natural gas serves about 21% of world's energy. Now, apart from fossil fuels, we need to know other sources of energy. These include water, wind. Sun is the great source of energy. It gives us heat and light, and nuclear energy. Now we need to learn them one by one. When we're just starting this chapter, I had shown you the dam, and I was telling you that water can be used for creating or originating or generating the electricity, because it is also the source of energy. So we shall see that how these things are the sources of energy. Let's talk about the water here. Water as the source of energy. Hydroelectric power is generated. But a hydro always indicate water. Hydro means water. Just keep in your mind for your lifetime that hydro means water. Whenever you see that word hydro, that means water. That means water. That means water. As I told you, that temperature, when you see the word therm, that would always indicate temperature. Therm would always indicate temperature. Likewise, hydro will always indicate water. Hydroelectricity, if you know the meaning of hydro, you will come to know that what kind of electricity it is. How? Hydroelectric power is the power which is electricity that is created by, that is generated by the water. But if we are having a glass of water, of course we cannot generate the electricity with that. There is a particular way, there is a particular, like we can say that scenario, there are particular things which are required. So hydroelectric power is generated by turbines. It is generated by turbines, and these turbines are driven by falling water. Let's make it easy. For example, there are some of the generators. Here you can see the picture. These are like, this is the water. This is the generator. What is it? It's a generator. This generator can only work if the water is fallen over it with the power, with the speed. So that is why we just make the gate or the canals like this, due to which the water can fall with the great speed. And when these, like we can say that when the water strikes the generator is started. That is why this generator is now producing electricity. Here you can see the powerhouse. Okay, it is generating what? It is generating the electricity. And this electricity is generated by the water. So that is why we call it as hydroelectric power or hydroelectricity. I can give you, fill in the blank or true false. I can give you that. Hydroelectricity is the electricity or the form of electricity which is generated by dash. So you must know that is only be the water, because it is hydro. It can never be the coal. We know that coal is used for the electricity. Petroleum can be used for the electricity. Gas can be used for the electricity, because we can have the generators with petrol, with CNG. Okay, in case of load shedding, we use the generators by giving them some of the fossil fuel like petrol or CNG. But that is not hydroelectricity which is generated by those engines or those generators. Hydroelectricity is the electricity or the electric power that is generated by water. Dams are built to store water in artificial lakes. In artificial lakes, the water is stored. Why this water is stored? If this water would be stored, only in that case it is possible that this water will fall down with some speed, it will start the generator. One more thing I want to clear here is that we do not use the sea water for this. We do not use the sea water for making the generating the electricity. So we need to make the artificial lakes, and we then call it as dam. Okay, beta, there is a last point I need to show you, that water is released is in pressure that generate electricity, as I told you. Uranium is basically a radioactive element, and it is used to make the electricity, or it is used for the energy as well. You might have seen the mills like this. Okay, they usually uranium is used. It is put into a nuclear reactor that produce amount of energy. Uranium is radioactive element. There are some of the radioactive elements from which one is the uranium that is used for creating or generating the electricity. Now, sun, we know that sun is the great source of energy. It gives us heat and light. Solar panels, solar plates are also called as solar panels. Solar panels convert solar in energy, which are used to convert sunlight into electricity. Now, here is the wind. The thing which you need to remember about wind is it is free and it is constant source of energy. It is free and constant source of energy because we do not use to give water to it. We do not use, we do not need to give anything to this. This is constant. If there is a wind, the generator would be started. The generator would start creating the electricity. Right, so it is free and constant source of energy. Wind generators converts the motion of wind into electricity. It is a valuable source of energy, but it is costly method. How? Because the generators which are attached over here are very expensive. Okay, so that is why we call it as expensive method. Some facts about energy resources in Pakistan. You need to read out this from your book as well. If we talk about, particularly here, we are talking about the Pakistan, okay? Keeping this thing in mind that here we are talking about the Pakistan. Okay, so coal is mainly found in salt ranges around Quetta in Lower Sindh. Pakistan has low quality coal that produces a lot of smoke and ash. Okay, we are not having the good quality coal. If we talk about the oil, oil fields are located in Potwar Plateau. Okay, here you need to know that this is the example of plateau, and this is the, you can see that the source of oil. From here we can get the oil. And the Lower Sindh, Lagari oil fields are the largest in Pakistan. Now this comes, which is important. Lagari oil fields are the largest in Pakistan. That is not important for your syllabus, but this is also important in the point for your general knowledge as well. Okay, so in the Pakistan, the largest oil fields are Lagari oil fields, right? So natural gas, most important source of energy in Pakistan. Okay, particularly Pakistan is dependent on natural gas. The gas fields are located in Balochistan, Sindh, Punjab. The largest gas field is at Sui. We call it as Sui gas because there is an area, there is a city named as Sui where there is a largest gas field is at Sui, that is the area. The second largest is at Mari. Now, electricity can be hydro. Here again, we are talking about the Pakistan. Here are, if we talk about the hydroelectricity, I told you hydroelectricity is something which is created by the water. So here we are talking about the dams. So for the Pakistan, the two main dams are Mangla Dam and Tarbela Dam, right? There are more of the dams which are under construction. Maybe they would be, their project would be completed or not, we don't know. Thermal is something which is showing you the fossil fuel, okay, because this gives the temperature heat by burning coal, oil and gas. Thermal electricity is the electricity which is created by burning these things which are fossil fuels. Other sources are here. This is beta. I have taken these lines from your book, so you can read out this thing from your book as well. Here I need to tell you one important thing, that is about biogas. This biogas is very important. It is produced by cow dung and human waste. It sounds awkward, but it is reality. Biogas is something which can reduce the pollution. This is very important. The world is working on this. Many of the scientists are working on this because it is highly productive. It is highly beneficial for the people. Okay, it can reduce the pollution as well. For example, if you are having the garbage, so that land trash, that is the land pollution, we can destroy it. So what do? We just burn it. By burning, the pollution is not decreased. Pollution is changed into one form to another. The pollution which was in the land form, it is now in the gas form, or in the that is now becoming the air pollution. So we are not having something which is very productive, which is very beneficial to reduce the pollution, but the biogas. Biogas is now, you can say that it is something which is produced by the cow dung and human waste, and the world is working on this. Okay, you can also search it on the Google. Nuclear energy is also important. Here we are talking about the Kanab and Cheshnab. This is, you can see that the abbreviation of Karachi. It is the Karachi power plant. Okay, this is the nuclear power plant of Karachi. This is the nuclear power plant of Chashma. Okay, so you need to remember these two nuclear. So beta, here comes your book pages. Your book pages here, I have underlined the important lines. All around us, what is causing the things to happen? That is energy. That is energy. This is important. Okay, there are three main fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are something which when they are burned, they give heat. Okay, here it is about oil. It is on, let me come to the next page. Here I have underlined the main lines. You can underline these lines in your book as well. Okay, and this page is having all the information of Pakistan. So thank you so much. This was all about your today's topic. Now I'm going to share the Google form with you. So I want students to be active in the chat box, and they'll be telling me the answers in the chat box. Okay, class, I want all the students to be active. The instructions are same as yesterday. As I told you in the science, that there would be no limitation for the responses. You can attempt the test once, twice, thrice, several times. You can do it again and again until you get the full marks, okay? And please, beta, do not use your book while completing this form because there is no restriction. The marks are not included in your examination. So no need to be worried. Just feel free to attempt it, okay? As this is your revision test, which is final test, or this includes all the chapters, okay? So I'll be having the quick review. I'll be reading it fast. So I want students to be active in the chat box. I am not supposed to disclose the answers here. Number one, Mughals were the descendants of Dash, Genghis Khan, Tamerlane, or both? That is very good, Bita, very good. Dash was the founder of Mughal dynasty. Hurry up. Dash was the founder of Mughal dynasty. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Babur wrote his life history with the name of Tafsir-e-Babur, Baburnama, Zindagi Ka Safar. Very nice. Excellent. Ayan, what you are writing, Bita? Write properly. Dash was an Afghan chief. Sher Shah Suri, Akbar, or Aurangzeb? Hurry up, class. You need to be quick. We are having just 2.5 minutes. Yes, very good. Dash was the last Mughal emperor. The last Mughal emperor. Okay, students, if you are you need time to write, so you can just tell me A, B, C. While writing option A or B or C, it will help you to write quickly, okay? Yes, very good, very good, very good. Dash are made up of hard rocks, hills, valley, mountains. Very good. Good. Mountains usually have dash shape and steep sides. Very good. Excellent. The highest point of the mountain is called Dash. Very good. Just write A, B, or C, so it will not take time, okay? Smaller mountains are called Dash. Smaller mountains are called Dash. Very good. Very good. Excellent. Muniba, Arham, everybody's giving the right answers. Dash are very large areas of flat land. Yes. Bita, don't be confused in plains and plateau. The answer is plain, because if the statement was, if the statement would be the dash is the very large area of flat land which is higher than the main land around it, then in that case it would be plateau, otherwise it is plain. You will find most of the towns in Dash. Mountains, hills, mountains, plains, or hills? Hurry up, A, B, or C. Hurry up, class. Quick. Very good. They are mostly sunny and dry lands. Very good. Dash is a piece of land that is surrounded by the water. A, B, or C? Very good. Cactus plant can grow in Dash. Very good. The coconut is common and tropical island, tropical desert, or tropical mountains. Very good. Australia is an example of plateau, hill, or island. Very good. Thar in Pakistan. Many of the students gave me the wrong answer of this question. Beta, Thar in Pakistan is the example of desert. That is desert, okay? Dash is the largest desert. Come on, hurry up.